Hey guys, and welcome to this video. In this video, I'm going to teach you about application programming interfaces or APIs. Now this can be quite a confusing subject. I think it was quite a few years before I really fully understood what they were from when I first started hearing about them. And it was never really explained to me that well, but APIs are integral to the cloud, so they're a really important concept. Now let's start off by talking about ports and protocols, just for a bit of basis here. So if we're using a computer to connect to Amazon.com, so the website Amazon.com, we're going to be using a browser. Web browsers use a protocol, that is HTTP, the Hypertext Transfer Protocol, or HTTPS, which is the secure version with encryption. Now, the protocol is essentially the language that's used for communication over a network. So HTTP is used over the internet. It's a really great protocol for the internet. It's very reliable across the internet, which can have varying performance. Now, on the Amazon side, there's something called a port. And the port is going to listen for incoming connections. So I often refer to it as a door behind which a service is running. So there's lots of different doors with different numbers on them, just like in the hotel. And behind each of those doors is a service. So in this case, there's a web service. And web services run on port 80 for HTTP and port 443 for HTTPS when we have encrypted connections. So these are common ports. Now the HTTP protocol has something called methods. They're sometimes known as verbs as well. We have the GET method. This is retrieving information. So when you're connecting with your browser to Amazon.com, your computer needs to download some pictures and some text, maybe videos, and display that information onto your computer. So it's performing a GET request. Your browser is submitting a GET request to Amazon.com. Now, if you're uploading data, you're going to be using POST or PUT. So the POST is the method used to submit data, to upload something, and then if something needs to be subsequently replaced, then we're using the PUT method. And then there's the delete method as well for deleting data. There's more than that, but those are just a few to give you an idea of what the HTTP methods are. So coming back to our example of Amazon.com, the computer is submitting an HTTP GET request to the web server, and the web server is then returning the content to the client. Okay, so why am I talking about ports and protocols and HTTP? The reason is with APIs, we're actually leveraging these common protocols. So an API, it stands for Application Programming Interface, and it's essentially a set of rules and protocols that allow computer programs to talk to each other, just like a web browser talking to a web server. The APIs assist with sharing information and data between those programs, and they leverage standard protocols like HTTP. So when we're leveraging the cloud, we're actually able to speak to Amazon or AWS in this case, using HTTP via an API. AWS have APIs, and those APIs define the actions that you can request on AWS. So it's almost like a menu in a restaurant, and you can choose what you want. So what action do you want to perform on AWS? Maybe I want to launch a web server. Maybe I want to delete something. Maybe I want to create a database, or maybe I want to create a new user. Now the computer here, which is on the internet, is able to use the AWS management console in order to perform actions on AWS. Even when you're using the management console, everything is resulting in an API call to AWS. So it doesn't matter whether you're using the management console, the visual interface, the command line interface, or if you're a developer writing code using an SDK, you're always speaking to the AWS API. So maybe here somebody wants to create a new user account. So they do so through the visual interface of the management console, but on the back end, what's actually happening kind of behind the scenes, if you like, is an API call is being made to AWS. And it's going to use that language of the internet, HTTP, to speak to the API. So that means we're able to leverage the common language of the internet. We're able to leverage HTTP and the GET, PUT, POST, etc. methods in order to perform actions on AWS. So it's a really great method of leveraging the internet and those standard protocols and web browsers in order to manage the cloud. And in this case, a user has now been created on AWS. So every single action that you take on AWS is actually an API call. Again, whether you're creating databases or deleting Amazon S3 buckets or updating a virtual server on EC2, everything is an API call. Let's have a look at some more examples. So with Amazon S3, we have the get object API action. So you can imagine this is actually going to result in an HTTP get request, and that is to retrieve objects from Amazon S3. In other words, download a file from S3. It's just a storage service, basically. So here we have the API for S3, and through the management console, we're issuing an HTTP get. In AWS language, that's an S3 get object request. And in response, an image is downloaded to the computer. We could also upload objects to the bucket. So here we're going to issue the put object API call. We have a PDF on the computer, and we're able to issue the put object, and that PDF file is then uploaded to S3. So essentially, every action that we want to perform on AWS is going to be an API call, and we're leveraging this protocol of the internet, HTTP, in order to make those requests. I'll give you another example that you may be familiar with. Here we have a flight aggregator service. So this could be something like Skyscanner, Momondo, there are many others. So here you might want to fly from, let's say, New York to Dallas. So you put in your source, your destination, the time and date that you want to fly. And what they'll do is they'll actually go out to the various airlines and find out which flights might suit your needs. So we're searching for flights, and what they're able to actually do here is talk to an API. So each of the airlines will have an API, which means that the flight aggregator essentially just issues a request that says, this is the information that we want to find a flight that fits this criteria. And then the API will return the results, and you as a purchaser can then choose which flight makes sense for you. So that's APIs. It's a concept that's super important for the cloud because, as I've mentioned a couple of times, everything in AWS is an API call. So every time you're changing something, an API call is being made.